everyone. My name is Jenna Fondren. I'm the manager of the Safe School Institute for Crime Stoppers of Houston. I'm so excited to be with you today. This video is part of our cyber safety conversations in partnership with Sprint. Sprint, thank you so much for everything that you've done to support our cyber safety initiative here at Crime Stoppers. Cyber safety is the number one hot topic that everyone wants to talk about because it greatly impacts everyone's life. Whether you're a student, parent, educator, law enforcement officer, we use the internet every single day, and we are trying to guide conversations in order to keep you safe and keep you aware. My role within the Safe School Institute is working with anyone in a school-based setting. So working with students, kindergarten through 12th grade, working with parents, educators, law enforcement, constantly trying to open the door to conversations that just help them guide how to never become a victim of crime, how to stay out of trouble, and just how to protect your loved ones. So today, our conversation will be centered around how the internet is permanent. This is something that we talk about with all age groups and something that is a main focus point of all of our cyber safety conversations. The best way that I can introduce this topic is by giving you just a little bit of insight as to what you're agreeing to and choosing to use social media. You know when you have to download an app for the very first time and you're going and setting up your account, and the first thing that pops up is that annoying little box or window in the middle of your screen, and it says terms and services, terms and agreements. No one reads it. You just scroll to the very bottom and then press agree. Well, when you agree to an app's terms and services, you are now agreeing to your content is permanent with that application. That app now owns your content and they keep it. When I tell students this, their eyes go about, you know, so wide, they start thinking to themselves, Snapchat and Instagram and these apps have my content. And we don't tell them this to scare them. We just tell them this so that they're aware and knowing that their content isn't going anywhere. As long as these apps are working, these apps are still functioning, that app has their information. Another, just a caveat, I guess, to how these apps own their content is law enforcement also has the ability to obtain records through various methods if we need to find them. So if a student is reported for doing something illegal or offensive or inappropriate or cyberbullying another student on an app or on the phone through text message, we can pull up those records because everything that you do on the internet, everything you do on your phones is permanent. And really when you're talking to any student in your life about this topic, it's not to scare them, it's to inform them. We can't take away social media, it's just part of our lives, but we can educate and we can help prevent and keep make sure that they're just staying safe and staying healthy. When it comes to the internet being permanent, third thing I want us to be aware of, screenshots. You guys, we can screenshot anything. You can take a picture, snapshot, whatever you like to call it, of content online. So when talking to students, I always use Instagram as my example. I will say, you know, hey guys, I can post a picture to my Instagram account and I have the ability to go back and delete it if I don't like the way it looks or I changed my mind. But within that time frame of me leaving it up for a day or even 30 minutes, there's a high probability that a couple people, 10, 20 people have screenshot my photo. And now that photo can be passed to anybody and it could be spread around. That photo is now permanent. Even though I've deleted it, not only can someone have a screenshot, but the company, Instagram, they also own my photo because I uploaded it to their app. So again, just trying to get students to realize like the long-term effects that it has when you're posting on social media. Last thing that I'll cover with you guys is how whatever you post online can definitely affect future opportunities. I never want a student's reputation to be ruined because of something they've posted. you know, I really hope that they get into whatever school they want to get into. They're able to get whatever job they want. And I never want an opportunity taken away from a student because of what they've posted online. And this is hard. This can be really hard for students because when you're 10 years old versus 16 years old, you think really differently. When you're 16 years old versus 20 years old, you think really differently. And you don't necessarily think about 10 years from now, 15 years from now, will this picture impact my life? And we are just asking students to understand that something they posted 10 years ago, 5 years ago can absolutely impact their future because the internet is permanent. This is a small insight to what we talk about when going into schools and going into communities to speak about cyber safety. But parents out there, adults out there who are watching this and do have students in your life, talking about how the internet is permanent is one of the top five things that you should be focused on when it just comes to basic safety. So please keep that in mind. We really hope you enjoyed today, and continue to check out everything that we do on our website, our social media, Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, and keep up with us. And we hope to, you know, see you soon. Thanks, you guys. Bye.